tree tenderly.
The Rosemary Clooney Show, with four guys called the Nelson Riddle and his orchestra are very, very special guests.
Julie London.
Here's our star,
Rosemary Clooney.
Find a cozy spot to cuddle and coo. Just us, just we. I've missed an awful lot. My trouble is you. Oh, gee, what are your charms for? What are my arms for? Use your imagination, just you. Just me, I'll tie a lover's knot round wonderful you. Oh, gee, what are your charms for? What are my arms for? Use your imagination, just you. Just me, I'll tie a lover's knot round.
Thank you. And hello there. Well, here we are again with a full crew aboard, including the high-lows, our very, very special guest, Miss Julie London, and, of course, lovable Nelson Riddle, his orchestra and his dimples.
Rosemary, I do not have dimples.
Sure you do. One right there and one right there.
Do you think Julie London will notice them?
I tell you what I'll do. I'll make a special point of telling her.
Gee, thanks.
That's all right. But right now, let's all make a point of paying close attention to this message from our host. Unlike Mark Antony, at this point, I'm come to praise Caesar. Irving Caesar, who, when he's not writing safety songs for children, also writes lovely, lovely things like this.
If I forget. What should I forget you? Then may I ever know the bitter, not the sweet, my love. And may I never find a friendly hand to greet my love. And let this heart of mine forget that it must be my love. If I forget, if I forget you.
Well, now that we've rendered unto Caesar the things that are Irving's, let's see what's new with four of the noblest Romans of them all, the Hilos.
I paid a visit there last summer, and I know I've seen the chairs. They come out by the dozens out of that
place.
Why
do you argue? I know that this chair was made
sorry that they're
lying. What's the trouble here, fellas?
Well, it's Gene with some more of his facts out of thin air.
They're out of North Carolina.
The facts?
No, chairs like these.
Michigan.
North Carolina.
Well, what difference does it make?
Well, I'm just tired of his being right all the time.
Well, why don't you turn the chair over and look at the label?
Yeah.
Oh, made by the Carmichael Furniture Company of Grand Rapids. In plant number 3, Pineville, North Carolina.
Aha!
Well, I almost had him.
Now what are you going to do?
We're going to rock.
Well, go! Gather around me. Here, children, I have a little story for you. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful movie star. And this movie star never got a chance to sing in any of her pictures.
Oh.
You know what this beautiful movie star did?
What?
She went out and recorded a whole album full of songs and lived happily ever after.
And?
Julie is her name.
Thank you.
cried a river over you.
After hearing Julie sing, I'm sure all of you would like to meet her. So, audience, meet Julie London. Julie, the audience.
Hi.
How do you account for the tremendous success of your very, very first record, Julie?
Well, I owe it all to the same people who gave Come On to My House its big boost.
The disc jockeys. Bless them, huh?
That's right. They asked for the single record be made of Cry Me a River, and then they played it and played it and played it.
Boy, you know, so may I add, did all the rest of it. Well, then, how did you get your start in pictures?
Well, by elevator.
What?
Elevator. Dorothy L'Amour was discovered running an elevator, and so was Jane Russell.
True.
And so was I. In fact, I ran the same elevator Jane did.
No.
Hi, Julie.
Hello, Julie.
Hi, Julie.
Hi, fellas.
Oh, you know the Hilos, do you?
Oh, sure. I've even sung with them.
I didn't know that.
Well, to be perfectly accurate, we sang against each other.
You see, I was working in a nightclub with very thin floors.
Right upstairs, over the club where we were working.
Uh-huh.
Ours had a very thin ceiling.
And you know how loud we could get.
Oh, and a couple of times it sounded like I was singing Cry Me a Rocking Chair.
Julie, if we sang very quietly, would you mind if we sang you a song?
I'd love it.
Good.
Well, I tell you something, you know, we've got to change our dresses right now.
Oh. But don't you worry, I'll be listening in the dressing room.
All right.
You can pretend that we're still here, though, Jean.
All right.
And I want you to use this for inspiration.
Hey, fellas, look at this.
I took a trip on a train, and I thought about you. I passed the shadowy lane and thought about you. Down on some little town, and with each beat peeked through the crack and looked at the track, the one going back to you. And what did I do? I thought about you.
Could you hear us all right?
I sure could. It sounded just wonderful. You know, there's such a nice thought in that song of a guy that's so in love with his girl that everything reminds him of her.
Mm-hmm. Well, it doesn't have to be that way. You know, he could be good and sore at her.
What do you mean?
Well, like this. I took a trip on a train and thought about you. I passed a shadowy lane and thought about
you. Oh, Rosemary, don't mind him. He's just mad because he had to give the baby the 2 o'clock bottle last night.
Oh. Say, Rosemary, how come it's taking Julie so much longer than it did you to change?
Wait until you see what she's wearing, and then you'll understand.
Once I had a man, sweet as he could be. Once I had a man, and he was oh so right for me. Kind of sandy hair, eyes so soft and blue that you couldn't help but care. When he looked at you, he called me baby. But I pushed him away, wouldn't let him near, pushed him far away. Now I'm wishing I could hear him call me baby, baby, all the time.
Love the way Julie sings.
Oh, uh-huh. I'll bet the 82,950 inhabitants of San Bernardino are mighty proud of her.
Mm. You know, you're such a demon on facts that I'd like to hear you give out with a few about yourself.
Oh, that would be very dull. But you talked me into it. I weigh 125 pounds. I'm 5'7½". Eyes blue, hair crude.
You came out to California to sing your way to fame and fortune.
What fortune? I made more money selling popcorn.
Really?
Uh-huh. You see, I could buy a bushel of popcorn for $12, and I could sell it for a gross profit of $80. Had a crazy popper that popped 13 bushels an hour. So that in a good week, I could make from between $300 to $400.
Mm. In either case, then, you came out with a pretty good income.
Yes, in either case.
In either case, you came out with a pretty good income, didn't you?
In either case.
Here we go again.
I say either.
And I say either.
I say neither.
And I say neither.
Either.
Either.
Neither.
Neither.
either.
Let's call the whole thing off.
I like potato.
And I like potato.
I like tomato.
And I like tomato.
Potato.
Potato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
Let's call the whole thing off.
But oh, if we call the whole thing off, then we must part.
And oh, if we ever part, then that might break my heart.
So if I say pajamas,
and I say pajamas,
I'll say pajamas,
and I'll say pajamas.
For we know we need each other, so we better call the calling off, off. Let's call the whole thing off.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
I wonder if you wouldn't mind staying here and kind of looking after things while I go over and get ready for the next number.
Oh, sure thing.
All right.
Don't run.
Okay.
What a great gal. Well, now that she's gone, there are a few facts I can tell you about her. She was born in Maysville, Kentucky, latitude...
Gee.
What? Already? Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Rosemary Clooney.
Thank you, Gene. A few years back, Johnny Mercer wrote a score for a show called St. Louis Woman, which included, along with a lot of very fine music, the ballad I'm going to do right now. While the song is familiar, I think you'll find that something new has been added. Nelson Riddle has written what I think is the finest arrangement I've ever heard. Listen.
Nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine. High as a mountain and deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things.
Our show for tonight. Nelson Riddle, you never sounded better. Julie, thank you very, very much for coming over.
I enjoyed it. Good night, Rosemary.
Good night, Julie. Hi, Lowe's.
Bye, Rosemary.
Goodbye, Rosemary. Bye, Rosemary.
Bye, Rosie.
Boy, that Julie London sure does make an impression, doesn't she? Thank you all for joining us this evening. Till the next time, then, good night, everyone.